Hi, I'm Adam Stephen Kelly, and I'm one of the writers and the director of Kill Kane. Well, I've been quite closely associated with British crime films for the last couple of years through my work with the producer, Jonathan Sothcott. And this script came to me, and I thought it was just a bit different because, I mean, British crime movies are, you know, ten a penny, but a lot of them aren't really very good. But something about this script was a bit different. It wasn't really like the normal sort of vigilante movie where this guy is just suddenly going on this killing rampage of killing people and avenging, you know, whatever's happened to him. It was something a little bit different, and it was a bit of more of a human story, which really attracted me to it. And the funny thing about this film with Vinnie Jones in was that originally he was supposed to play one of the gangsters, so he was actually going to be one of the roles you would kind of associate Vinnie Jones being in. But the difference was he signed on to play that role, and then he actually said, wait a minute, this is a really good script. I love the character of Ray Brooks, this family man whose wife and kids are killed in front of his very own eyes, and he turns vigilante. And he thought it was a different kind of character to play, something he's not really done before in such a way. And that just kind of, I thought, well, that's something a bit different for Vinnie Jones, so let's do it and see what happens. I think there's a real sort of gritty realism to them. I mean, these sort of things, you know, no matter the subject of these revenge movies, whether it's like Kill Kane, where there's a home invasion and a guy's wife and kids are killed before his own eyes, that can happen, and it does actually happen. And I think it makes people think, what would they do in a situation like this? Would they possibly, you know, do what Vinnie does in this movie? What feelings would they have? I think people can connect to these movies in quite an interesting way. That was definitely a conscious thing when we were in pre-production, thinking about, you know, how violent do we want this to be? And I think sometimes less is more in a way. Sometimes, you know, if someone gets shot in the head or something and there's blood and guts everywhere, it kind of does glamorize it a bit, and it sort of, you know, sort of almost makes it a little bit surreal, and you can, it doesn't sort of feel real. But in this, the violence is, you know, it's quite a violent film, but at the same time, it's not gratuitous in a sense. It's very real, and it was a, you know, we wanted to make it feel real and like this could actually happen. Yeah, we shot this film in Wales. I actually directed my first short film done in Wales, and for some reason I ended up back in Wales for the feature, Kill Kane. This film was shot in 9 days, which is some sort of probably a world record for a British crime movie. It was an insane schedule, just 9 days on the trot. We had no money to make this film. It was just pure, you know, passion from everybody involved to make this. And I mean, with the locations, when you've got no money, you don't really have that many to work with. And sometimes things fall through whilst you're shooting, and especially with 9 days. But I mean, the film was set in Essex and we were shooting in Wales, so we tried to do our best to mask the fact that it was in Wales. But I mean, you know, it's a no-budget movie, but I think we managed to achieve something that looks, you know, really, really good. Well, obviously, everyone knows Vinnie Jones. Sean Cronin, whose name is being batted around quite a lot these days for, you know, being a villain or a supervillain, as he calls himself. I think Sean's great. You know, he can play menacing, and he's exactly what we want. You know, this film is called Kill Kane. He is Kane, and he embodies that role, and he's a bit of a nasty piece of work, but it's a fantastic performance. His sort of cronies in the film, Benjamin Way playing Billy and Connor Boru playing Connor O'Brien, new talent on the block, and I think these have very, very strong performances in this film, and are really, you know, on the they show what they can do in this film, and I think they're going to be talent to watch, as is Sarah Alexandra Marks, Michael Bailey, and of course, back on the experience end of the stick, Nicole Faraday from Bad Girls, who plays Kim, Vinnie's wife in this film, another fantastic actress delivering another fantastic performance. So we've got a great cast. It's an interesting mix of old and new, but I think it works really well. Well, I've got to be boring, and everything I'm doing is top secret, so I can't really divulge too much. But as I mentioned, I've done a short film a couple of years ago that did really well and went to Cannes and everything. And I want to make a sort of trilogy of short films that are connected to Dunin in a way. So I'm working on the second one now, which is called Dear Diary. We'll be filming that later this year, and it's going to connect to Dunin in an interesting way. And it has a really interesting lead actor attached to, which I can't talk to about, but it should be good. It should be fun. I mean, I've only just done the one short film before I did the feature, so I think it is still a springboard to bigger things. And I mean, there's nothing like film school or anything that can kind of prepare you for an actual working set. And with Dunin, that's exactly what I was able to do. I mean, I went from doing 2 days on Dunin to 9 days on a feature, and most people kind of get a bit more time when they make their first feature. Alas, I didn't, sadly. But I don't know. It was just, it's a wonderful experience to start making shorts. And obviously there's, you know, a million film festivals that you can get your work seen, your name banded about with the internet now. And of course, crowdfunding campaigns. People no longer have to, you know, raid their savings to fund these films. And it's becoming a more realistic thing to be able to do and do well, because now people, you know, you can share your belief and passion in a project on the internet, and people are going to come in, you know, we're done in. They came in droves from all over the world to support this film and really believed in it. And that's how we got it made. And that's how many, many films are being made, and even feature films these days. So I think with the technology and advancement and everything, I think it's opening up a lot of doors. And new filmmakers are coming in different ways that they didn't necessarily do before. So I think it's a really interesting time for movies. Certainly means a lot. This is the first time I've ever done anything like this. So again, it's the first feature. It's an incredible venue. It's Sean Cronin is the guy responsible for setting this all up. So many thanks to Sean. It's just a wonderful place to be, BAFTA. I mean, what's better?